everybody, I'm Alex, and I'm one of the science kids. Today, we're going to be talking about the occipital lobe. Now, we've already talked about one of the lobes of the human brain, the frontal lobe, and how it is very important. We've also talked about what might happen when the frontal lobe gets damaged, so we're going to be doing the same for the occipital lobe today. So, what exactly is the occipital lobe? The occipital lobe is a lobe of the human brain that is responsible for gathering and processing visual data. Basically, when light hits your eye, it is flipped by the iris and the data is sent to the back of the eye or the retina. From here, that light is converted into electrical signals which are sent through the optic nerve. The optic nerves eventually cross, which means the data from the right eye goes to the left side of the brain and the data from the left eye goes to the right side of the brain. From here, the electrical signals go to the occipital lobe. The occipital lobe flips the image for you so you can better understand it, and it takes the light and the wavelengths of the light and converts it into color that we see. The occipital lobe will also process the brightness, so it will tell you if something is really bright or if something is very dark. Well, you might be wondering now, after the occipital lobe processes all this data, what happens? Where does all this information go? Well, the occipital lobe sends these signals to other parts of the brain that are responsible for association, memory, and processing and thinking.
If you're watching our video right now, the occipital lobe will process that information and send that data to the other parts of the brain that will tell you,
this is a channel I should subscribe to. So now we're going to be talking about what happens if the occipital lobe gets damaged. Well, many things can happen if the occipital lobe gets damaged. Maybe your vision gets all blurry.
Alex, are you okay?
Maybe you start hallucinating.
Sophie, why do you have a bird on your face?
What are you talking about?
Sorry, got beaten up by Billy.
But right now, we're going to be talking about three of the weirdest disorders that are a result of occipital lobe damage. Well, prosopagnosia is a disease where you lose the ability to recognize people's faces.
Hey, Alex, how's it been? How are you doing? Do you want a cup of water or something? How are you?
No, thanks. I'm sorry, who are you?
Well, you might be thinking, oh, this is probably not that common. I won't be affected by it in my lifetime. Well, it turns out that 600,000 people are affected by this disorder in the United Kingdom alone. Now, if you thought that was weird, just wait until you hear about visual anosognosia. Visual anosognosia is a disorder of the occipital lobe. It's also called Anton-Babinski syndrome. It's very weird. Basically, people don't have any visual data coming to them, but they don't know if they can't see or not. So people that have this disorder will make up that they see something.
Hello, can I ask you a few questions today?
Yes.
I'm here.
What? Oh.
I'm here. Okay, can I ask you a few questions?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How many fingers am I holding up?
Avocado? Visual anosognosia is one of the weirdest diseases ever, and it's definitely the weirdest disease I've ever heard of. Another very interesting disorder that arises from occipital lobe disease. Another very interesting disorder that arises from occipital lobe damage is homonymous hemianopsia. Yes! In homonymous hemianopsia, only one side of the occipital lobe is active, so you only see one side of the world, and you can only realize that you see one side of the world when someone points it out to you. You don't actually think about it.
Okay, so what's the shape of my face?
Semicircle.
Also, why are you wearing a monocle?
That must be scary, not knowing that you're not seeing half of the world. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for our next two videos. Don't forget to check out our social media pages on our website shown below. And as always, science is everywhere and in everything. Bye!